Hi, everybody, and welcome to Exegetically Speaking, a podcast of the friends and faculty of Wheaton College, Wheaton, Illinois, and the Lanier Theological Library in Houston, Texas. My name is David Capes, and I am the Senior Research Fellow at the Lanier Theological Library and a former dean up there in Wheaton at the School of Biblical and Theological Studies. Our purpose in these podcasts is really very simple. We want to promote the study of biblical languages, Greek, Hebrew, Aramaic, so we can read the Bible more faithfully, study it more fully, and not just read it, but to live it. Joining me today in Exegetically Speaking is Matt Norton, who graduated from the undergraduate program in 2017. He went on to do his Master of Arts in Biblical Exegesis in 2018, and now he's studying for med school, going to LSU. Matt, good to see you.
Great to see you, Dr. Capes. Glad to be here.
Thanks so much. Hey, how did you get started reading Greek? Let's just talk about that. Why? What interest did that have for you?
Yeah, so the first ancient language that I studied was Latin in high school. It turned out to be my favorite subject. In my senior year, I was actually the only student in AP Latin. So I was that guy. So I'd realized that I had a passion and a love for learning languages, and especially sure. Ancient or classical languages. And I started to think about, you know, its application to biblical studies. That was something I was interested in. At different points along my journey, I was interested in maybe going into mission work and Bible translation or pastoral work, whatever it may be. And so just for the purpose of being able to study the Bible in its original language in both Greek and Hebrew, I did a little bit of Hebrew study as well. I wanted to, you know, be able to do that. So my first semester at Wheaton, I was studying Greek. And once again, it was usually my favorite class all the way through.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. Now today you're heading to med school, and part of this whole series that we're talking about with alum is that in fact, not everybody who gets a degree in biblical languages goes on to teach or to preach. They do other things. So tell us a little bit about your journey into med school.
Sure. Yeah. So just over the course of my time at Wheaton, like I mentioned earlier, I love studying Greek. I love studying Hebrew. But especially as I got into the graduate level, just for a number of reasons, began to feel like it wasn't the best fit for me personally. So once I, you know, decided that maybe it wasn't the best fit for me vocationally, began to look at different options, I suppose, and eventually decided on medicine. I guess I shouldn't say eventually. I decided fairly quickly from the time that I began to reevaluate my options. And immediately after I graduated from Wheaton in 2018, less than a month later, I was sitting in undergraduate level courses alongside college freshmen taking intro, chemistry, intro, biology, all that kind of fun stuff. So it was an interesting and humbling experience, perhaps going from graduate studies back to, you know, studying alongside 18-year-olds who had never done it before. But it's worked out to this point and got accepted to med school recently, and I'll be starting later this month. So
well, part of this is your dad's a doctor, right? And then your father-in-law is a doctor as well.
Yes, sir.
So you, in a way, you're keeping the family business going.
I suppose so. Yes, sir. Yeah. It's not something that I had planned to do all along. Like I mentioned, I had other career plans, you know, throughout college, but eventually decided that I felt like this was the best fit for me as well and too as well. So
that's great. Well, today we're going to look at Philippians 4:13, passage that you said you're interested in, and I'm interested in that as well. I'm curious about your read of it. So what's going on in Philippians 4:13 exactly?
Sure. So Philippians 4:13 is a verse that a lot of us are familiar with, you know, some people's favorite verse. And kind of a traditional interpretation of it is, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, or through him who strengthens me. Mm-hmm. Now, the interesting thing that's going on here in the Greek is that that phrase, I can do all things, comes from the Greek panta iskuo. Mm. And panta is just the accusative neuter plural of pos, so all things, and the accusative is very often translated as a simple direct object of a verb. But it gets interesting because you then have ischuo, which means I am strong or I am able. So that's an intransitive verb, so that actually can't take a direct object if it stands on its own. Because if you just translate it, you know, literalistically, you have I am strong all things, or I am able all things, which doesn't make a whole lot of sense.
Yeah. Yeah.
So then we have, as an interpreter or translator, we have a couple of options. We can either supply a verb, which a lot of translations have decided to do. They say, I can do, and they insert that do, say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Or another option, this is my preferred interpretation, is to treat the accusative there, the panta, is what's called the accusative of respect.
Right. Yeah.
So what that comes out to is something like, I am strong with respect to all things through Christ who strengthens me, or I am able with respect to all things through him who strengthens me. And this comes out to a meaning that something like, you know, I can endure all things through Christ who strengthens me.
I mean, part of the context here is the fact that Paul says, I know how to be content. I know how to be abased. I know how to abound in any circumstance, right? So does that figure into how you're thinking about it?
Absolutely. So what this comes out to in terms of meaning is something like, I can endure all things through him who strengthens me, rather than I can do all things through him who strengthens me. And a couple of benefits or advantages of this interpretation is I feel like it's a little bit more grammatically straightforward than the traditional interpretation of I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, right? You're not having to supply that verb of to do. You get the meaning of it just from the words that are actually there in the text.
That's a great point.
A little bit more contextually consistent, right? Because in this passage, Paul is not talking about great feats he's accomplished or things that he's achieved. You know, he mentions that he's been in want, he's been hungry, and he talks about how he's been content through all these things. So he's talking about things, difficulties or hardships that he's endured and remained contented and hopeful through because of his faith in Christ. And then thirdly, I would say that it's really a more robust theological meaning to say that, you know, I can endure all things through Christ who strengthens me, as opposed to I can do or I can achieve all things through Christ who strengthens me. It's a little bit more profound and realistic and honest, I would say.
Yeah, I think it's a bit more transparent, to use, it's an overused word. One of the things I like about your reading of it is I've often heard people say, you know, I can do all things, and the focus is on doing, right? Yeah. In fact, that word is not even in the text. You're emphasizing something that's not there. It's just, I am able with respect to everything to be strong by the one who empowers me.
Yeah, no matter what comes, he has that mindset.
Yeah, which I think is a great reading of that text. It's very honest. It's very true. It's very contextual. And I think you're spot on there. Matt, good luck in medical school. Keep us in your prayers, okay? And we will keep you in ours.
Sounds great. Thanks so much for having me. I enjoyed it.
Thanks for being with us today on Exegetically Speaking. Thanks to Ian Rosine, Rebecca Larson, and Silvio Vasquez, who helped us produce this podcast. Thanks as well to John Alonzma, our Wheaton-based director, who makes this podcast possible. We're grateful to Phil Keggy for our music. If you want to study biblical languages, then you need to consider Wheaton College, whether you're an undergraduate or a graduate student. We have amazing programs, our first-rate faculty, and some of the best students in the world. So go to the website, www.wheaton.edu, and look for Modern and Classical Languages. Get started today. If you have questions about this or any of our podcasts, we'd love to hear from you. If you have suggestions or questions about any passage in the Hebrew Bible or Greek New Testament, send us an email and we'll see if we can get one of our experts to weigh in on that for you. Our email is exegetically.speaking@wheaton.edu. That's exegetically.speaking@wheaton.edu. Thanks for listening.